This is a city where music underscores everything. Because in New Orleans, there's music in life, and there's music in death.
It's important to understand that New Orleans is the most Africanized city in America. Because the French were very lax with the slaves, the Africans who were brought here were able to retain a lot of African culture. In African culture, we don't look at death as the end. We look at it as the next phase. And you're supposed to celebrate that. Second line is based on New Orleans jazz funeral, where you have the band leading the family down to the gravesite. That's the first line, is the family and the band, and it's very somber. And on the way back, whoever else joins in, that becomes the second line. And it's really a party.
The second line is like a magnet. They draw all kind of people, and you know, they all walk on the streets together like in one big old pile.
This is how we end off a party with a great second line, baby.
That's oh, it. Watch out, watch out, yo.
If you go to a second line, as the band playing, a couple of people will pick up something and play with them. I don't care if it's a bottle or a stick, a screwdriver hitting on a stop sign, they will find something just to be part of what the band's doing. New Orleans is just related to music, and it's just our DNA.
We moved to a different beat in New Orleans. The influence of the Mardi Gras Indians and the second line band are then us every time we get ready to write a rhyme. What it is a lot of chanting.
Call and response is a big part of it, right?
I love it. I'm about to show you what it is.
All right.
When I say cheeky, you say black. I'm cheeky.
Black.
I'm cheeky.
Black.
We rocking, we rolling with cheeky.
Black.
You moving, you grooving with cheeky.
Black.
I love the way you really sing it with cheeky.
Black.
Turka.
Oh, I forgot that one already.
Twerk some.
Some. I forgot it. It all connects. The Mardi Gras Indians, the second line sound. You heard all that good stuff like that at block parties, and it's the beat. It's the beat that get the feet moving and the hands clapping and the people jumping.
On that note, block parties here, were they a big thing when you were growing up?
Oh, most definitely. You say they got a block party here, everybody meeting at that location. You got guys on motorbikes, you got girls in their high shorts. Wherever the girls go, the fellas will follow.
Block parties really used to be in a project. You know, we used to just call it the DJ. And that's how a lot of DJs made a name for themselves.